Hi guys, it's Otto here, and today we're looking at how to recognize whether your system is I/O or RTS. And you don't always have the luxury of seeing the label on the motor, and it's a lot of work to take it out, so we have to go from what's easy in determining what system you have, which is the remote control. Now we have two smooths here, and I'm going to show you how you can determine whether it's RTS or I/O. On the I/O models, they have an indication that it's I/O, but you can also check it by just pressing a button and you'll see the LED flashing, and that's green, so that means that it's an I/O system. If you can turn the remote around, because if it's not been installed yet, then you can also see that the back is green and there's an indication of I/O. So that's an easy way to determine whether it's I/O or RTS. Now the RTS version, there's no indication that it's RTS, but you can check it from the LED as well. Just press a button, start flashing, and it's red. And red means it's RTS. When you flip it around, it has a red back, and it also a little sticker that indicates RTS. So that's an easy way to determine whether it's I/O or RTS on a smooth origin RTS, smooth origin model as we've shown here. So let's see if that works with other remotes as well. For example, this one. If I press a button here, you see that the LEDs start flashing and it's green, which means it's I/O. And when you actually turn it over, you can see there's an indication here that it's I/O. This is actually a Situo 5 I/O. Let's take this one. I'm going to press a button as well. It's red, so that means that it's an RTS model. And when we turn it over, it's actually a TELUS 1 RTS. So that's an easy way to determine which system you have. Now, how is this even relevant? Well, if you want to expand your system with sensors, for example, or you want a control system like Tahoma or Konixun, Tahoma works with both, but Konixun, you need either an I/O or an RTS version, so it's important to know which one you need. So if you want to expand your system, it's good to know which system you have, whether it's RTS or I/O, and this is the best way to check it, because taking out a motor is a lot of work, and from the invoice or the documentation you get from the installer, it isn't always clear. So that's an easy way to check it. Now, if you have any questions about expanding your system, RTS or I/O, let me know. My details are in the description below the video. So send a message and I'll gladly help you. Thanks for watching. I'd like to see you in the next video.